Hey guys, one of the things that I've learned about using a diode laser, especially like the Emblaser itself, is that it is absolutely critical to keep the lens clean. Now, a lot of people say to me, Gil, I understand that, but it takes a bit of time for me to clean the lens. It's actually really easy on the Emblaser, and the instructions themselves are actually embedded into Lightburn, so it's not that hard to do, but I want to show you right now, step by step, how easy it is to clean the lens on this Emblaser. Let's get to it. So I've got an Emblaser machine here, and I'm going to show you the steps to actually clean the lens on the laser unit. Let me introduce you to the laser unit, and that's this piece right here. It's actually made up of three parts. On the top you see a fan, you've got the laser body here, and of course the warning sticker, so that should help out. And you've got a hood, and that hood is actually really important when you're using air assist. So the first step to get access to the lens is to actually take this hood off, and you can do that quite easily. It's actually made out of silicone, and it doesn't take too much force, and it actually comes off. Some people pull out the tube, I leave it this way, and I put it off to the side. In the laser body itself is the lens, and the lens is actually, the lens housing is right here, right down below. Now normally, when you think about it, lefty-loosey, righty-tighty, but because the way this is actually configured, if you're looking from the front, you actually have to turn it to the right to get to the lens. And I'm gonna do that right now. So I take my fingers and I turn it to the right, and I can feel it coming along. It's kind of interesting, in the sense that normally this would be tightening it up. And what I actually will have now is the lens housing. So as you can see here, there is the lens and the lens housing. I'm actually going to now go to the desk because I want to do some work with this. And I'm going to show you how to take the lens out of the housing and actually clean it and then reassemble your Emblaser too. I'm going to now take the lens out of the lens holder. And to do so, I'm going to actually grab a quick lens tissue. And I have one that I prepared earlier. And I'm going to turn the lens over here and actually pop it out. And I put it all over my fingers. So one of the things I want to clean is all the natural oils that are on my fingers. I want to get them off. One of the things I want to show you here is that the lens itself is not always flat. There's a flat surface and a rounded concave surface. That rounded surface needs to be up when we put the lens back into the lens holder. I'm also going to take one of these wipes. These are lens cleaning wipes. You get some of these with your machine. I'm going to open it up, and this is what I'm actually going to use to clean it. It's a little bit like those cleaning napkins you get at fast food restaurants. Take the lens, place it on the side, and then just really gently kind of massage it in. I'm not putting any pressure whatsoever on that. I'm actually doing that just to make sure that the bulk of it comes off, and then I'm going to actually take it out and take a look at what's going on. At this point, if there's anything on there still, I'd like to make a little bit of a triangle here and just gently get anything else like that off. This is something that you'll actually understand more when you go through the process yourself, but you want to get that absolutely as clear as possible. The lens is the magic when it comes to diode lasers. If you're not happy with that, or if you've got some more material or stuff on the lens itself, you can actually use the tissue just to dry and get anything else off that. I'm really happy with that. That's to how I'm seeing it right now, that's crystal clear. I take my lens housing, being sure that the curved surface of the lens is going to point up, and without touching the actual outside surfaces, I drop it back into the holder, and using the tissue, just gently coax it back into the holder, he says. Now, I haven't done it right this time. Let's see if I can get it back out without destroying the surfaces. Okay, let's go and pop this back in. Oh, it's a little tricky because it's not falling in straight. Oh, there it is. Give it a quick wipe, and you can actually see there that rounded surface is at the top. That lens is now clean and ready to be put into your Emblaser 2. So I've actually cleaned the lens, it's all ready to go back in, and now I just reverse the process to actually reassemble the machine. I have the lens in here, and just need to turn it to the right now. So actually to the left, excuse me, I'm turning it to the left, and I'm just right now, I'm just kind of playing with the thread, because what I don't want to do is force it on there. It is made out of aluminium, so it is metal, but at the same time, you don't want to re-thread anything. That's a little tricky. I think I've got it. Let's see. Yep, I've got it. Now, if I were to touch the lens now, I'd have to go and re-clean the whole process. So just be a little bit careful with that. And I've now got it on. I just tighten it up. You don't have to make it super tight at all, but it's nice to go all the way to the threads and just give it a little bit of a pressure. That's it. Take the hood, and all I've got to do now is just kind of squish the hood back on, which I've done, and that is done. My lens is now clean, and I'm ready to put some material in and start using my Emblaser 2 to the best of its abilities. It's that simple. I really think if you are not on top of this procedure, this is actually something that I do almost every couple of days, or if I'm cutting material that burns off like oils or a little bit of smoke, that all collects on the lens itself. So I actually do that every single day, and if I'm not getting the results I want, I'll actually do it in between the cuts themselves. It literally takes a few minutes. Once it's done, you will see that your machine comes out and operates almost like it's brand new out of the box. If you like this video, hit subscribe and the bell icon and hang around for more tips on using diode lasers in the workshop or in your classroom. I'll see you real soon.